chapter 4. Moreover, he made an altar of brass, 20 cubits the length thereof, and 20 cubits the breadth thereof, and 10 cubits the height thereof. Also he made a molten sea of 10 cubits from brim to brim, round in compass, and 5 cubits the height thereof. And a line of 30 cubits did compass it round about. And under it was the similitude of oxen, which did compass it round about, 10 in a cubit, compassing the sea round about. 2 rows of oxen were cast when it was cast. It stood upon 12 oxen, 3 looking toward the north, and 3 looking toward the west, and 3 looking toward the south, and 3 looking toward the east. And the sea was set above upon them, and all their hinder parts were inward. And the thickness of it was an hand breadth, and the brim of it like the work of the brim of a cup with flowers of lilies. And it received and held 3,000 baths. He made also 10 lavers, and put 5 on the right hand and 5 on the left to wash in them. Such things as they offered for the burnt offering they washed in them, but the sea was for the priests to wash in. And he made 10 candlesticks of gold according to their form, and set them in the temple, 5 on the right hand and 5 on the left. He made also 10 tables and placed them in the temple, 5 on the right side and 5 on the left. And he made 100 basins of gold. Furthermore, he made the court of the priests and the great court, and doors for the court, and overlaid the doors of them with brass. And he set the sea on the right side of the east end, over against the south. And Huram made the pots and the shovels and the basins. And Huram finished the work that he was to make for King Solomon for the house of God, to wit, the 2 pillars, and the pommels and the chapiters which were on the top of the 2 pillars, and the 2 wreaths to cover the 2 pommels of the chapiters which were on the top of the pillars, and 400 pomegranates on the 2 wreaths, 2 rows of pomegranates on each wreath to cover the 2 pommels of the chapiters which were upon the pillars. He made also bases, and labors made he upon the bases, 1 sea and 12 oxen under it. The pots also, and the shovels, and the flesh hooks, and all their instruments did Huram his father make to King Solomon for the house of the Lord, of bright brass. In the plain of Jordan did the king cast them, in the clay ground between Succoth and Zeredatha. Thus Solomon made all these vessels in great abundance, for the weight of the brass could not be found out. And Solomon made all the vessels that were for the house of God, the golden altar also, and the tables whereon the showbread was set. Moreover, the candlesticks with their lamps, that they should burn after the manner before the oracle, of pure gold. And the flowers and the lamps and the tongs made he of gold, and that perfect gold. And the snuffers and the basins and the spoons and the censers of pure gold. And the entry of the house, the inner doors thereof for the most holy place, and the doors of the house of the temple were of gold.